Hey, it's Mark, maakudesuyo. In this video, I'm gonna show you guys a glimpse of what it's like to be an Amazon packer. The following clips were filmed on different days during the pandemic, including my very last day working for Amazon in December of 2020. By the way, this is a traditional non-sort facility which handles mostly larger and or heavier products. This is why you won't see the Roomba-looking robots that Amazon likes to brag about, and instead you'll see OP machines that people ride to go as high up as 40 feet in the air. Just like that one. Right here I'm working on an HOV pallet, which means all of the items in the pallet are the same. The brown paper is called dunnage and we put it inside the box so that the product doesn't move around too much while the box is being handled. As you can see, we don't have to tape the boxes, we just slide the box over to the conveyor belt where it goes to the taper who uses the taping machine to tape it shut. This piece of paper is a gift receipt and they often contain messages like happy birthday, congratulations on the baby, and hey baby, I miss you so much. I don't know what that was. Anyways, moving on. Right here, I'm working on a regular cage which has a variety of items inside. Some of the items, just like this one, is SIOC or ship in own container, which means we can ship it as is and we don't have to put it inside an Amazon box. Some of the boxes that we have, such as this one, cannot be taped using the tape machine, so the packer has to tape it themselves using a handheld tape gun. This is pretty time consuming, so a lot of people avoid items that use these kinds of boxes, especially when they're trying to meet their productivity goals for the day. Generally, the productivity goal for packing single unit items is somewhere around 65 packages per hour. Weird flex, but my fastest was 220 units of all SIOC and about 160 units that are boxed. Yeah, come at me, bro. This person with a cart full of boxes is called a water spider. No, really, they're called water spiders. One of their main jobs is to keep the box suite filled up with boxes so that the packer can pack uninterrupted. Even though this facility handles mostly larger and heavier items, we do come across smaller items like these, and they come in those yellow totes. And what we have to do is put them in small boxes like these and tape them up ourselves using a handheld tape gun. This particular station is specifically for SIOC or ship in own container items. It may sound easier because SIOC items don't have to be put into a box, but a lot of the items that go through here are really big or really heavy or both. Also, because these are all SIOC items, anybody who works in this station is expected to hit a productivity goal of over 100 packages packed every hour. Large and or heavy items are placed onto a cart to be given to the ship dock people directly so they can load it into the trucks. Because of the pandemic, I had the pleasure of packing dozens of 45-pound weightlifting bars, weightlifting plates, and hundreds of dumbbells. I really hope you're enjoying your home gym. I'm sure many of you noticed the outdoor umbrellas that a lot of restaurants set up in response to the pandemic so that they can have outdoor dining. Guess what? A lot of these umbrellas came from Amazon, and I packed a lot of them. Unfortunately, a lot of these umbrellas are registered as ship-in-own container even though they don't have boxes. Whenever I have an item here in the SIOC station that doesn't have a box already, I just bring it over to BOD or Box On Demand, where they can create a box of any size, just like magic. Thankfully, there are boxes that fit these umbrellas, and I try to find them so I don't have to bother the BOD packers. I hope you are all having a wonderful time dining outdoors. Bonus footage. This is what it would be like in the point of view of a product being packed by an Amazon packer. Soft dunnage. That's called the spoo label. Whee! Onto the conveyor belt. So that guy right there is called the taper. He has his own dunnage machine, and this is what it's like to get taped. Ooh. The tape machine simultaneously tapes the top and the bottom, so it's a lot faster than having to use the handheld tape guns. Then the package goes up and around the conveyor belt, and then it goes back down and heads over to what's called the slam machine. The slam machine scans the spoo label indicating what item it is, and then puts a shipping label on it, and then it goes over to the ship dock people, and then they load it into the trucks. These packages go through a weighing scale right here that confirms whether or not the packer placed the right item or the right amount of items into the box. Traffic jam, boom. The slammer will come in to manually fix that. Up there are where the shipping labels come down from, and if the machine didn't read the box correctly or it saw that the weight was incorrect, it's gonna kick out to the left side here where the slammer will confirm if it's the right item. Otherwise, it goes to the right side of the fork all the way to the ship dock people and goes into the truck. That's a day in the life of an Amazon packer.